Hey everybody, it's Paige, and today's video is going to be a makeup haul, but not just any makeup haul, it is a drugstore makeup haul. My boyfriend Jarvis and I went to Walmart the other day because we had to pick up a couple of things, and I just happened to stumble across the makeup aisles. I don't know how I got there, and I actually picked up quite a few things. I also picked up one thing from Target, so I'll let you know what that item is, but I'm really excited to share everything that I bought with you guys. I also wanted to let you know that I did just film a video on this makeup look. I did a full face of makeup that I forgot about. I will have that video linked down below in case you haven't seen it yet. Also, my lip combo, I need to tell you what it is because I am so obsessed. I am wearing the MAC lipstick in the shade Honey Love, and then I have the new Alamar Cosmetics lip gloss in the shade Birthday Suit on top of that, and I am obsessed. I love it so much. This is the perfect combo in the entire world. So yeah, anyway, if you guys are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy, and let's go ahead and get started. The first product that I'm gonna show you guys is the one that I picked up from Target. This is from Physicians Formula. I saw this and knew that I needed it immediately. It is so beautiful. So this is a palette and it has 6 different products in it. It is actually a collaboration with this person right here. I'm actually not sure who this is, so I definitely will look her up after I finished filming this video, but I was just so drawn in by the palette that I had to pick it up. I took off the plastic wrap so that you guys could see it a bit better. So it looks like we have mostly blushes. Oh no, we've got bronzer, blush, and like a couple highlighting products. So this is so beautiful and I cannot wait to use it. I have been loving the butter formula in general from Physicians Formula, so I feel like I'm really going to love this. Everything else that I'm going to show you guys, I purchased from Walmart, and this entire haul actually was started with this product right here. This is the L'Oreal Blush Please Shimmering Blush in the shade Blushin' in Riviera, and someone actually posted a picture of this in my Discord. Her name is Kara. She's part of my Twitch fam, so thanks Kara for making me spend so much money that I didn't need to, but she said that supposedly this is supposed to be a dupe for the NARS Orgasm Blush. Now, I have not confirmed or not confirmed that claim quite yet, but I definitely will. But either way, this is a gorgeous blush. And they have 2 shades, but this is the only one that they had in stock at the Walmart that I went to, and I cannot wait to use it. So yeah, I think the packaging is so adorable. Like, everything about it looks stunning. Then, while I was looking at the blush, I saw they had a bronzer, so of course I had to pick this up. This is their Bronze Please Sun Powder Face and Body Bronzer in the shade La Terra. I believe this is the lightest of the 3 shades. It is huge, and it actually looks so nice. I can't wait to use this. I'm seriously so excited about everything that I picked up. But once again, the packaging is just so freaking cute. I feel like these look so good together. So yeah, I got those products from L'Oreal. Then I was strolling down the aisle and I noticed packaging that I didn't recognize, but it was from a brand that I did. So then I was like, that's interesting. So apparently the brand Hard Candy revamped a ton of their products and they have a bunch of new packaged products. Well, they're not new products, but they're newly packaged, if that makes sense. So I saw these and I was drawn in by the packaging. These are from Hard Candy, like I said. So we have the Sheer Envy Long Wear Setting Spray, and it says it is 12-hour wear and it is a hydrating, there's cucumber extract in here. I hate cucumbers. I hate the smell of cucumbers. So I hope this doesn't smell like cucumber, but I guess we'll find out. But the packaging was just so cute. Like, look at that. And then I saw this primer, oh, that's backwards, and it matched in packaging, so I was like, well, I have to get that one too. So this is their Sheer Envy Long Wear Primer, and this again says that it has 12-hour wear and that it extends and sets makeup. I will for sure do a testing new drugstore makeup video or something like that, but yeah, I'm really excited about both of those products. I used to love Hard Candy back in the day. Like, I was obsessed with their packaging. I wanted everything from Hard Candy, but I feel like it wasn't a brand that was super talked about. I just would always see it and just be like mesmerized by like the cute kind of different packaging. Next, I picked up a couple of face powders, and if you have seen my powder drawer, then you know that I did not need a single additional powder, but I got 2. So this first one is from Rimmel. This is the Stay Matte powder. This is like an iconic powder that I feel like people used to use all of the time, but I haven't heard anybody talk about it in forever. I got this in the shade Sandstorm. I think they have a translucent shade, but they were out of it, so I went with this one. Hopefully the color is okay. I've never used this product before. The packaging is very simple and it doesn't feel super luxurious, but Rimmel's prices are on point, so I'm really excited to try this out. And I kind of like the packaging, like even though it's like feels like it's gonna break at any moment, I kind of like it. So I picked that up, and then I also purchased this one. The packaging definitely was a factor in this purchase. This is from CoverGirl. This is the Clean Fresh Healthy Look Pressed Powder. I got it in the shade Light Pale 140. Hopefully this works out for me. I think this is this a powder foundation? It says that it absorbs oil and delivers fresh, naturally flawless looking skin, formulated without phthalates, mineral oil, formaldehyde, talc, parabens, and sulfates. Buildable coverage, lasts all day, lightweight, flawless finish, makes pores less visible. And it comes with a vegan puff for ease of application. So I did a review of the Clean Fresh line. CoverGirl actually sent me a PR package, and it came with every single shade of their Clean Fresh foundation, as well as a ton of other products. And I actually did not like the foundation. I did at first, but there were these bizarre chunks in it that, like, I don't know how to explain it. I tested multiple shades, and I had a lot of people tell me that they also experienced this problem, but then I also had a lot of people tell me that they experienced nothing of the sort. So I don't know if it was just like a hit or miss kind of thing or what, but it didn't end up working out for me, even though everything else about it was great. But this, I figured there wouldn't be any weird foamy chunks in my pressed powder. At least I hope not. So I decided to pick this up, and the packaging is so beautiful. Like, I love that. Hopefully the color is okay. Once again, I had Jarvis with me, and I was like, how does this color look? You know, and he was like, that's all right. And I'm like, well, what could be better about it? And he's like, I think it's good. So who knows, you know, they don't have mirrors there, so you can't like compare, you know, it might not work out, but hopefully the shade does. But the packaging is so cute, and it sounds like a great product. And I don't have anything like this, like a powder foundation. I used to use the Clinique Double Wear. No, that's a different brand. The Clinique, what is the name of it? I used to use it every single day. It's like a pressed powder foundation, and this is kind of reminiscent of that, so definitely gonna give that a go and see how I like it. And then I bought a ton of lip products from Maybelline. We've got a combination of both liquid lipsticks and lip glosses here, and wow. Like, wow. So the first two that I picked up are these. These are their Superstay Matte Ink Liquid Lipsticks. They had a whole line, like it was probably like 5 or 6 shades of these like coffee-inspired liquid lipsticks. So they were all like nude-ish, like brown tones, nude tones. So stunning. And these were the two lightest shades, I believe. So I really hope that I like these colors. I love this formula. I actually have one of these in my everyday makeup drawer, and I love it. This is in the shade Loyalist, and it's actually a bit different in color than the packaging. So this looks very intimidating to me, but on the lips, it's stunning. So I'm really excited to swatch these. I haven't even done that yet, so I'm gonna do that right now. This first one here is in the shade Hazelnut, and it's kind of like a pinkier color. So, oh man, it's like stuck. Oh, I don't know if any just spilled, but hopefully not. Ooh, that is so pretty. So this definitely, I would say, matches the packaging. It also smells, I think it's supposed to smell like coffee or something. I think it smells like coffee. I don't know. I'm not a big coffee person. Like, I really do not like coffee, but I loved the color. So this is beautiful. It's a bit deeper than what I normally go for, but this is gonna be like gorgeous in the fall. And then I have this one here, which is in the shade Chai Genius. And this one, ooh, wow, that is a deep brownie toned nude right here. But once again, it is so stunning. I'm gonna go ahead and swatch Loyalist just so you guys can see what I'm talking about so I'm not crazy. So this is the packaging. It is a very light pink, but when you put it on the lips, it is a bit darker. So do you see what I'm saying? You see how that's nothing like the packaging? This is a gorgeous lip color. I highly recommend this shade. However, these ones look, actually they're a little bit darker than the packaging, but they're a lot more similar in my opinion. And then the last few products that I picked up are all of these glosses. So when I saw these on the end cap, I was like, whoa, that looks like KKW Beauty. Like that was my first initial reaction. Like, wow, do these look like KKW Beauty? But no, they are in fact Maybelline. So they had a ton of shades and I picked up four, which is so extra. But I picked up this one here, which is a gorgeous glittery like gloss. It's just kind of like a clear one. It's in the shade Pearl. So let's go ahead and swatch this. Ooh, they have a really big doe foot applicator. Yes, that is so pretty. I'm sure you're not gonna really be able to tell, but it's right here. It has a bit of an icy kind of glitter to it. That is so pretty. That's gonna be gorgeous as a lip topper. Then we have this one here, which is the shade Ice. And this is a really pretty light pink kind of color. I'm guessing it's gonna, yeah, it definitely comes across, at least when I swatch, as a straight up clear gloss. Like there's hardly any pink tint to that. So once again, more of a natural kind of gloss. Then we have this one here, which is called Reef. And this one is definitely a jump deeper. This is the nice like pinky kind of corally kind of color, and this one has quite a bit of pigment. Wow, I wonder what these smell like. I don't smell anything. Maybe like faintly. So here's that gloss right there. That is so pretty. And then we have one more, and this is, by the way, these are called the Lifter Gloss plus hyaluronic acid. I didn't even know that. This one is called Amber, and this one is more of a warm toned, kind of like orangey nude color. Ooh, wow, those have really good pigment to them. That is so pretty. I am so excited. And once again, this packaging is everything. Look at that. One of my favorite parts about KKW Beauty is their packaging, which, I mean, you know, I like the brand a lot. I love their products, at least most of the ones that I've tried, especially their lip liners. And this totally could pass as a KKW Beauty lip product. Like, feel and everything. Oh my gosh, that was almost scary. They actually feel really, really nice. They feel heavy duty, and I love everything about them. I cannot wait to play around with all this new makeup. I will definitely do it in a video coming up very, very soon. I want to say thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed today's video, please don't forget to subscribe and give it a thumbs up. Also, just so you guys know, I actually just posted my very first video over on my gaming YouTube channel, which, if you didn't know, I really enjoy video games, especially Fortnite and Animal Crossing, and I made a whole separate YouTube channel. I don't know if it's gonna work out or not, but I thought I would give it a shot, so I posted my first video. It's a Fortnite stream, and if you guys are interested, I will have my channel linked down below so you guys can go subscribe, check out the video, whatever you feel like doing. So yeah, anyway, I love you guys so, so much. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye.